I'm very much against the rainbow color map.
Because it could be really misleading to decision makers. And by decision makers, sometimes I mean you and me. So here's the rainbow. This is the typical default color map. Right, so where would you use this? It often gets used when people are talking about weather, and they use it for all kinds of different things, like either precipitation or, in this case, this is Hurricane Florence, and the colors are giving probability of tropical storm force winds. This was actually from a Wall Street Journal article that was a rant against the rainbow color map, where they were saying decision makers were looking at this region up here where it looks like there's just this band of yellow and green, and then it quickly drops off. But the light blue that's right next to this yellow and green is just a 10% less probability. So it's not like it was a dramatic feature. It's just that this type of color map doesn't reveal the data in a way that fits with our perceptions. I can give you another example. So this is a plot that was from some paper. You could look at what it's about down here. Estimated fraction of precipitation lost to evapotranspiration over 3 decades. If you look at this plot, the thing that might stand out to you immediately is there's this line going right down the middle of the country. Like, oh my goodness, what dramatic difference is happening there? But if you go down and look at the scale, we're just looking at yellowish green and green. So those values are right next to each other. The values are continuous across what looks like a division, but the color scale isn't. So it messes with our perception. So just like people say, you can lie with statistics, you can lie with color maps, and maybe unintentionally see patterns where there aren't any. So one way around this is to use a color map that has a perceptual ordering. So the color map here on the right, I showed 2 different rainbow maps on the right. It's not clear, you know, what is red higher than yellow? Should yellow be between green? I don't know. There's no obvious perceptual ordering. But if you look at different shades of gray, you could actually put those in a proper order. So in some sense, even though it's not as colorful, grayscale is actually an advantage over rainbow map. This is an example from an actual paper trying to show regions of ozone. And they used a rainbow color map with no perceptual ordering. And it almost looks like they chose these, it looks like there's these frontiers that have been colored in, like this blue one right at the edge of the yellow and green, and then this red thing up here. These are supposed to be different fronts of ozone. And it's not clear. I mean, are we being fooled by the color map? We might be. You could actually take that same data, do it in the rainbow color map like we saw before, or use one that has a perceptual ordering here. So this is from white all the way up to kind of dark red. Things that look very dramatic in the rainbow, but don't really have much meaning, aren't there when you look at the perceptual ordered color map in the middle. If you start calculating the gradient of that, so where are there sharp changes, then those features come back. So it wasn't that the features were wrong, but we may have been misled by the color map. And so it's just a good thing to avoid. Plus, there are plenty of other options with color that do have perceptual ordering. These are just a few examples. If you just look up color maps, there's all kinds of color maps. There's like 2-color color maps where if you're trying to show positive and negative things in different spectrum, there's a bunch of ways to do it. This is just sort of a cautionary tale. Don't just use a default.
Please share your thoughts in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. I've got extra information and the links in the description.